Hello everybody, this is Sharon and I have a project I'd like to share with you. These are some Easter little rosettes that I created. Jamie at Snap and Scrapper, she was the one that actually gave me the inspiration to create these for Easter. And so I'll list the link to her YouTube channel in the description bar below. So what I did, this right here was already, I already had this and I use it just for different things like different occasions, for Christmas, Easter, whatever. Well, not Christmas because it don't have Christmas colors, but I've used it for Valentine's Day and Easter so far, and I just thought it would be pretty to decorate little things like this because to me these kind of look like flowers. And I'm gonna lift my camera up a little bit so you guys can see them a little bit closer, but they're just little rosettes. I can do a tutorial on those if you guys are interested. They were very simple, and you just fold them, you know, like the mountain and fold, the mountain and valley fold, and I can't remember the measurements right off because it's been a while since I did these, but if you guys are interested in them, I can do a tutorial. And and then I just use like a Martha Stewart punch around the edge right here on each one of them. And then these little images, I think I got these off of Pinterest. It said they were free downloads. So I printed those on my computer. And then I just colored them in like with my Copic markers. I put like the little white dots on their cheeks. And you know, things like that. Let me zoom in a little bit. And then I added these butterflies. I did some stickles and some flowers and things like that. Added a little bow down here to the bottom. So I did that on each one. Now this one right here is not really that Easterly, but I just thought it was so cute with the little cat and the umbrella. And then he has a little frog right here that's sitting in a flower. I did do some of the Winkostella on the flower, so they're kind of, you know, sparkly looking. Did the little bows here at the bottom, and I added these butterflies that I had created in an earlier video. And then the one in the back is, you know, just, it's very similar. I just did it the same way and did the stickles, the butterfly, and did a little bow down here in the bottom. And then down here, in case you guys are interested in this, in the jar, I did some rose petals down in here to kind of hold, well, that's a flower actually, but I did mostly rose petals down in here. I just kind of stuck those down in there to give it some thickness. I also have like the paper filler that you can buy at Michael's or whatever. I put that down in there as well. So that's how they turn out. I thought they turned out really cute. I just got those sitting in my kitchen and thought they turned out really cute. They kind of look like Easter, and they look like little flowers blooming too to me. So I have one more video, and I've got to get a different camera angle, and I'll be right back to share that with you guys. So I'll be right back. I almost forgot to show you guys my Easter rosettes that I had created. The other ones, of course, was for, Valentine's. The other ones were Easter. So here's one for the Valentine's Day. And so it's basically the same. You just cut out those. And then I printed off these little, on my computer, these little stamps. What I did is resized them so they would fit on here. And then I added this pretty lace trim in the back and this little bow right here. And these were on straws that I purchased at Michael's. So I thought they turned out really cute. And then I have another one here. It's basically the same. I just added this pretty lace trim behind it. And then I printed these off of my computer. Like I said, I resized them so they would fit the smaller circle here. And then I put some of these little dots on here. And did another bow and did some more of the lace trim and did some stickles. Not sure if you can even see that, but there's some stickles in her hair on her little cuff there. And then I did this one the same way. So I thought they turned out really cute. I put these in the little jar that I showed you guys earlier. I did that for Valentine's Day. And I added some more stickles here and some more of the little dots there. Lace trim there. So I just wanted to share that with you guys right quick. I meant to show you that earlier when I was doing the Easter ones. So I hope you like them. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye bye. Okay, everybody, I'm back, and this is a wreath. I'd like to thank Rena Myers for the inspiration to create this. I had seen where she had did one for the spring, maybe a month or two ago, and so I wanted to create one. And so what I did is just bought this wreath at Michael's. It's a 12-inch flat wooden wreath, and so that's how it kind of looked. I have one in here, and I was going to show it to you guys, but I don't see it right now. I'm just going to show it to you, you know, so you can see how it looked first. But anyway, so I just adhered the paper collection. It's from the Knitwick Collections, and I will list that in the link below in case you guys are interested. But I thought I would create this for some of our church members if they're having babies. Right now, nobody is, but if they are, I thought it would make a really good little gift for, you know, you could have a, this is like the little girl baby and then the little male baby. So in case they didn't know, you know, what sex they were having, I thought it would be a great little gift. They could hang on the door to the nursery, or like when they were having the baby shower, they could use it, you know, there. But anyway, we'll go ahead and get started. Like I said, I just layered the paper on the wood here. I painted it all the way around with some white acrylic paint around the edges first, and then I adhered this pretty lace trim that I got from an Etsy store there. Then I did some of the white pearls. I'll lift this up so you can see a little bit better. All the way around. That goes all the way around. Then I have a pretty applique right here that goes across the top right here. And then all of this came from the Knitwick paper collection. I put a little butterfly applique here. And then I have this kind of coming down. It looks like it's trailing from the butterfly. And I have a couple of appliques over here on this side and a little bow that I created. And I'm going to zoom in and see if I can do it a little bit better like that. It's kind of hard to show. Right in here, this is from the paper collection, so I just layered that across right there. And then in the background, I did a doily. And then I have a heart that I cut out from a die from the paper collection. And then I did two little bows there, just made out of string on each side there. And then at the bottom, let me zoom back out. Down here across the bottom, I just did like the little female baby here, printed that from the paper collection. And then the male baby is on this side. And then it says, we are expecting right here. And then I did a couple more bows there. If I can put it up here a little bit better. And then I did another little bow down here. And, you know, of course, used the lace trim and this white pearl trim here. And then on the inside right here all the way around, not sure if you can really even see that, I did like a little white trim that I purchased that at Michael's. So it hangs from like a seam binding bow right here that you can put on the door or whatever. And so that's it. I thought that would be, you know, really cute. Like I said, just to use, like, if somebody's going to have a baby or something like that. So I'm going to share that with you guys. So, that's it for this week. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.